Hey Twitch, this is Matt Grandstaff, Global Community Lead at Bethesda. I've got a special guest today from Bethesda Game Studios, Senior FX Artist, Mark Tier.
Hey, how's it going?
Otherwise known as Markypoo?
Yep, Markypoo. Yeah. Yep, that's the dev name. That's what the people call me around the office.
Yeah. So, Markypoo, what do we have today?
Well, we're going to take a little look at Nuka World. Just a little look. We're trying not to spoil anything, right?
Yeah, we're not going to spoil too much about the game right now. We're trying to cut the spoilers out. We just want to show you some cool parts from the beginning of the game. It obviously comes out next week, Tuesday, August 30th, Xbox One, PlayStation 4, and PC. We'll also be giving away some Nuka World-related prizes during the stream. We've got some mugs, we've got hats, we've got Fallout Monopoly. So just sit back and enjoy the stream. And Kevin, our man behind the scenes, will be picking the winners. So let's jump into it.
Yeah.
All right. So is this Nuka World? No.
Yeah.
No, this is Sanctuary. And this is an older version of one of my player saves. I feel like I say that with every one of these Fallout DLCs. But Mark, you actually went ahead and gave my guy a little outfit upgrade.
Yeah.
So he's looking good.
Yeah, we got something together, and we got a little something better we'll put on when we get into the prize winning section.
Sweet. So right now, like all the other Fallout 4 DLCs, I gotta go back to first person. Once you have the update, the 1.7 update is now out on PC, PS4, and Xbox One. That allows you to use Nuka World, so make sure that you have your Xbox set up to get the update. And once that starts, you'll get a little quest right here for Vault. No, where is it? There we go. Here's the quest. So we're going to access that, listen to Nuka Cola Radio. Hey, dog meat.
There's everyone's favorite song.
Yeah, sure to move up the charts. I've been loading up the trailers for YouTube and stuff, and I hear this over and over in my dreams now.
Yeah.
So that's who talking to each other?
There's Bottle and Cappy are going to be talking. You can see them here on my shirt. They're going to be talking to each other, letting you know, as a citizen of the Commonwealth, how you can go to Nuka World and enjoy your day.
So the Nuka Express. Okay. So I should get a quest pop-up. Yep, the map updates. And we'll pop it open here. And there's the song again. We'll listen to it maybe one more time. So yeah, that's close enough. Federal ration stockpile. And we'll fast travel over there. So how'd you guys get started with Nuka World?
Well, after we finished up work on Automatron, Al, the lead quest designer, Justin, the lead designer, Angela, the lead producer, and myself got together and started just coming up with ideas for the final DLC for Fallout 4. And it was just a matter of coming up with a bunch of pitches, taking those to, you know, Todd and the other various leads and seeing what stuck. And when we came with the title Raiders and Rides, that was the one that got everyone really excited. And you know, we had that associated with Nuka World in our very like short elevator pitch, and it was just like, all right, tons of Nuka Raiders, let's go with that.
Yeah, it was definitely something after the game came out that we saw a lot of people saying they wanted to do more with Raiders. So it was great that we're kind of able to wrap up the Fallout DLC suite with this.
Yeah, I mean, we look, of course, at what fans are asking for, and we think about, you know, we're thinking about what happened in Fallout 3 with the good and evil, and is there a way we could bring that back, whereas the sort of theme in Fallout 4 was sort of hope and rebuilding. You know, maybe we could turn that on its head a little bit and bring back some of that old evil gameplay. So that was something that we put into the pitch. And there was also a game jam from two quest designers, Kurt and Liam, and they had a Raider game jam that was all about the Raider gameplay, and that was something that a lot of people in the office responded positively to in the game jam, and yep. that sort of drove that one pitch too, which ended up getting people really excited.
Cool. So I think we're here. This looks all new to me. Got some bottles. There we go. Looks like a nice place.
Yep.
Here.
Yeah, there's some gunners here.
There we go.
That are giving you trouble. I put the chameleon armor on there for when you're crouching.
Watched it.
And I've got an Assaultron right in my grill.
So
panic.
So this DLC was definitely meant to be a higher level.
Higher than I can handle.
We wanted people who have been playing a long time, we wanted to give them a challenge. And so level 30 is when the radio signal pops. But really, you know, you might want to go up even higher than level 30 to have a really good playthrough and not get your...
My ass kicked.
I was going to say that. We can say
ass here, because this isn't how it went for me before. All right, I'm going straight to the missile launcher. Okay. So, ladies and gentlemen, hey, we actually loaded a save just for this.
Yeah, we did.
We'll see where we end up. Yeah. I want to be able to report back. All right, so that's the first death, which means our first winner is announced. And Mark, I'm gonna let you take the wheel.
I think I got a
wow. And our first winner, that's the name, Kevin?
That's the name.
Mr. Moya! Wow, you have won yourself a Nuka-Cola pint glass, so congratulations. Yeah, we'll DM you after the stream. And that
only five shell, here we go.
I love this gun.
Oh.
There we go. Right. Assaultron on patrol.
The Assaultron's going to give us some trouble here.
And the car.
All right, let's take the back route here.
Oh, nice. Trade secrets. Well, that's way better. There's a guy up here too, right?
Get something else here. Let's do this. I guess I will go back to this one.
I feel like there's a gun missing from what I thought we had.
Yeah.
Excuses. Excuses only mean more giveaways for people. If we die enough times, I'm just going to have to find new prizes. Kevin's leg.
All right, let me close the back door. So. Oh, failure.
Did you guys die again already?
Huh? Yeah, we did. But I think we need to save the...
What did you do to my save? You made it so hard.
I didn't do anything. I want to be able to... I was looking for the... I think we dropped a few guns because we were over encumbered. Let's get in here and
maybe a sneak with the launcher.
Right, we're gonna go in.
There you go. I think if we get rid of T-2000 here, that'll help.
The car's gonna go. Hopefully that'll help us.
There we go. Yikes.
He's just running me down.
There we go. Nice, there we go.
You all took a look. Oh, look who's crawling
out.
Oh,
that's awesome. Terminator action right there. Uh-oh. Finish him, dogmeat.
I think the turn radius is going to be affected by the crawling.
I think you got him.
All right.
Oh, so we have to give away another prize, I just realized, because of your death. So, we've got this giant-ass Nuka-Cola beer stein for drinking Nuka-Cola, of course. Moonbree, you are the winner. M-O-O-N-B-R-I, that spells winner.
You're dead!
It should be coasting now.
I think there's one heavier. This might be her commander.
There's a guy up top too, I think, on the bridge. Or overpass.
Yeah.
Good thing we had like 15 stim packs to start with.
Yeah.
Would have been helpful if I used
and I can't bet because of the
Commander Kaler is a stim pack.
I'm getting
get out of there.
Yeah, let's just get through here. Alright.
We did it. We survived,
kind of. Yeah.
Level 30 or higher. Apparently level 51 isn't high enough for us. And so this takes you to the transit center, and I think we're just going to...
Yeah, we're going to skip this section here.
Skip some minor spoilers and get to the other side of the Nuka rail. Rough start.
Hey, well...
We'll make it.
It's harder than it looks when you come down here and have to do it on demand. It's much easier back at my desk.
Just a reminder to folks, we are selecting the winners from chat. This is not a raffle situation, so exclamation point raffle is not going to win you anything here. So just enjoy the stream, and we'll be announcing winners that are participating in watching the stream. Cool. Hey, were you wearing that before?
No, we got a new outfit on.
Is that the shirt you're wearing?
Uh-huh. Yep.
This nice.
So the barrier to entry for cosplaying as your character while you're playing it just went down to whatever it costs to get this shirt off the Bethesda store.
Visit store.bethsoft.com.
Yes.
And yeah, that's pretty nice.
And of course, you can wear armor over top of it. So we'll give ourselves a little help here. Throw the chess piece over it.
Very nice.
All right.
Now you only see bottle. So we are in Nuka World now, right?
Yep. Yep. We've got off the tram here, and I'll point out something that you're going to want to do. You could even do this in the transit center after you mopped up all those gunners. Is start to look for our special trash. It's the sort of themed Nuka World trash, created from all the leftover funnel cakes and cups and sodas that were present in the park and in anywhere where they could sell it to you.
So you got tickets and now you got a token. And
yep.
We'll see more on that later. And plus there's a whole bunch of other souvenirs, glasses, and stuff.
Yep. Alright. So we don't have a lot of armor on, but this is where we're going to play a little game. Yeah?
Yeah.
We're going to try and make it through this difficult part without dying. And of course, giving away prizes whenever we...
I would definitely go into health right now.
Hold on a second. Holy. Oh, it got... did it get unfavorited?
Oh, because we...
Oh, we loaded the save. Excuse me. Okay.
Oh, that's right.
I had it favorited on the last save.
Since we're in the menu, do we want to put subtitles on?
They should be...
They're already on.
They are.
They are, okay.
All right, so there's a ton of turrets here. And we're in the gauntlet now. The raiders are trying to have their way with us.
Don't think your speech skill's going to help you here. Nice.
All right. More stim packs than I thought.
We needed more?
No, well, we may by the time this is over, but we'll see.
You got one, I think you got one low one right to your right, too.
Luckily, the turrets have a little window where they need to...
Oh, I got the collision.
There is an exploit for the turret, but it doesn't work for you here, where if you take out the motor on the turrets that turn, they actually turn slower and you can get around behind them if you just cripple the motor, but since we're in sort of a long, skinny corridor here, it's not going to help us.
How many we got? Like three or four left?
Yeah.
Oh, that was huge.
Now we've got a little... Uh-oh. Okay.
I was playing this part last night and almost used all my stim packs here and made it through the rest of this stuff just by the skin of my teeth.
Here it is, the assault rifle. That's what I was looking for earlier.
There we go.
All right. Sorry, guys. No prize from the turret room.
Right on you.
Oh, I spoke too soon. All right.
Nice work.
All right, you ready to take a stroll?
Yeah, let's see. I should be fine here.
Maybe a quick autosave so we don't do that room again if we...
Yeah, let's quick save. So... Lots of lockpicking.
Yeah, so there's ways to bypass things depending on your lockpick level. But it can all be done without lockpicking. If you get through here, I think you'll get a good advantage.
Got it. I'm the master of unlocking.
Of course, Dogmeat already snuck around there.
Let's see how long the gauntlet lets him enjoy that one.
Doing good.
Yes, you made it.
So there should be tickets in these?
Yeah, I mean, it's a random drop, but
bottles, Coca-Cola,
ice colas, yeah, park stuff.
This looks suspicious.
Yeah.
I always get Wonder Glue.
You gotta get the adhesive.
Nice.
Yes.
I'm a real novice. What? Oh.
Tesla trap. Watch yourself.
Can you disable those?
Yeah, if you sneak up on it, you can disable those. I don't know where the pressure plate is for that one.
And can you? But you can't.
Now that it's fired, I think it's
spent. Just done.
Right, yeah.
Okay.
But there's one later on in the gauntlet that you can. That's right next to you that I disabled earlier. Yeah, that's what I do to get through this part. Just blow everything up.
You would think that would set on fire, but I'm okay with it not. Yeah.
All doors lead to death.
Okay, Twitch. We have three doors, and we're going to take a break here to let you pick the door we're going in. Which one is it? Is it door number left, door number center, or door number right?
Those are Roman numerals.
Yes. That's technical speaking. Kevin, what are you seeing? What do we want? Three? All right. Go in there. Shit. Thanks, Kevin.
Middle.
Okay.
I think that monkey is playing your death march, bit.
Wow. Got some...
Yeah, the...
Failed people.
The quest designers had a great time writing all the...
Are we
ready to speak?
Oh, there we go.
Oh, you want to... Yeah, there you go.
Yeah, a little bit low there.
Yeah, maybe two of those.
Okay. And tons of radiation.
Oh, get that. No matter how intense the battle, I always have time to pick up...
And always loot. That is a lot of radiation, though. Okay, there we go. Good job.
That's it. Someone thinks he's a real tough guy.
Oh, I'm over-encumbered. What do we not need? Well, take one of those. That'll help
those
with that.
Great, yeah.
Where did I get those originally in the game?
Don't ask me that.
Okay.
I did not know. I saw them for the first time in your safe.
Yeah, they're pretty amazing.
If you ever listen to most of the people who talk about working on these games, you see things all the time that you didn't know were there. So now we're dropping down into access tunnels. That's sort of, there's like places in the park where you're sort of behind the scenes where the employees would be, or different Nuka-Cola happenings are going on that the park attendees wouldn't see.
Cabot House is what they're saying. Thank you, guys.
Ah.
I did do that quest. That was one of the last things I did before Automatron came out. I'm actually doing okay.
Oh, damn monkey. What? Call me crazy,
uh-oh.
But I think our bitch
what?
Got
nope, nope. This was a good. This was a good choice for weapons.
If you hadn't seen the higher
run.
If you hadn't seen the higher level turrets in the base game, if you didn't play high enough, you would have missed the incendiary turrets.
Okay, Nuka Cola hat. Wicked Gato, like a cat, won the hat. So the Gato in the hat. Yeah. There you go. Congrats. we'll send you a message. So I've died twice. You've died once.
Did I? I died. Yeah. I died at the transit center.
Yeah. The hat is adjustable.
He's not going to take it if it's not the.
It does have a sticker on it though, so the cool kids can wear their sticker on their hat.
Oh, come on now.
Do you wear the sticker on your hat?
I don't do the baseball hats. No.
Okay.
I just stay covered in a layer of hair everywhere. Oh, what am I doing?
There you go. Oh. I see it. Oh.
All right. I know where it is, though.
Sweet. Oh, what? Call me crazy, but I think our fixed got something against fun.
Rad rats. They're new, right?
Yeah, these rad rats are new.
They're terrifying.
If you've ever seen Charlotte's Web, there's a scene in there where the rat, I think his name is Templeton?
Yes.
He gorges himself on park food while the park's closed, or the fair food. And that's sort of the inspiration for one layer of the creatures in the park is sort of like the ants at the picnic or the rats stealing the food at night.
E.B. White's contribution to Fallout. Very nice.
Alright, we'll give. We don't have a lot of these.
You don't have a lot, but you just feel bad.
You know,
sorry,
feel
dog.
Bad. Meat. You feel bad.
And yeah, those. Every time I've had those rats, I've had to run away, and they actually, when you shoot them, they'll go down, but then they get back up.
See, there was the other Tesla, and you can disarm them there.
Nice.
Yeah, that one I always spot because it's right near light there.
What the hell? I see
Pat
Brahma move faster than this, Mick.
Oh. Uh-oh. Oh, something's behind me.
Is there another rat?
No, he survived.
So I put out a tweet about these aliens, and I said, waste a minute, because you can see the fakeness of them right at the waist. Everybody thought it was a spelling error. And I was like, it's not a spelling error.
Is that from previous transgressions?
It's just from bad puns. But then I put the wrong there in the tweet. And so it was an all-around failure. But there they are. Waste a minute. Not real aliens right there.
Yeah, so the Raiders have used things from throughout the park to sort of spice up the gauntlet a little bit.
Time for things to get dangerous. See if he survives. What's next?
have had varying levels of success at this point right here.
I'm trying to remember what comes up here. These robots, no. Huh. Oh.
Hello. You were lucky there.
So some new bots that are just sort of in storage down here, but they might make an appearance. I don't know the point.
Who's this guy right here?
King Cola, His Majesty. He's just a character from the Kitty Kingdom. We made a lot of little cutouts and different, you know, as you've seen the sculptures of the different cartoon characters that are in this sort of Bottle and Cappy family.
So can you name this whole family right here?
Oh, they're just all King Cola.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
King Cola Green.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, and those are, that look like a teacup ride type thing I saw in the trailer.
All right. Next one.
Careful.
Yeah. All right. This one needs to be done carefully.
Yeah, they break. Yeah, well, no, oh. No. Can you jump it?
I'll try. Oh, fair.
Get in there, sucker! Oh,
great. Well, it might be time for another prize. Let's see.
Oh, legendary. No, a legendary popped in here.
You got one behind you, too.
Right, let's see here. Oh, there's more than one. Come on, spin up.
Jesus.
He's taking a lot. Dang, he's charging you just, me. Well, when they go in that charge mode, they're blocking.
Yeah, step back.
Go past them. Oh, now I'm stuck in this hallway.
You are screwed. You are so screwed.
I should never have jumped over that one.
Prize time. That was rough. There's not much you can do there.
This is a tricky... tricky section of the gauntlet.
We've got another Nuka Cola hat, and this time, Senshmora! Nuka Cola hat, congratulations. We'll DM you afterwards.
Oh, we went back.
Whoa, there. All the way back here.
Oh, what?
Rough.
Call me crazy, but...
Maybe we can sprint through that minefield this time and see how that goes.
Our fixed got something
against fun. Rats on your left.
Hell yeah! Looks like our fixed got some unexpected playmate.
Oh, dog meat, dog meat. Take care of it, dog meat.
If you're just tuning in, this is a first look at an opening era of Nuka World. Comes out on Tuesday next week, so we're just giving you a little tease. Nothing really spoiler heavy. Just basically, we're going through some grueling combat.
Oh, fail! I tried to rush.
Nuka World, Nuka Cola hat. Kevin, who's our next winner? Want me to give it a shot?
Yeah. Go for it.
All right, let's see.
Next winner.
Next winner. You got that, Mark.
MRVESTH. Merveth.
Say it with heart.
Mervests.
There you go.
Okay. What? So are we putting the prizes that have been taken somewhere?
Yeah. We'll put that there.
At least you get to get some payback. The room that took you out last time.
What? Call me crazy.
I'm just going cheap. How many of these I got plenty to mess around with? Here we go. go. One left?
Yeah.
One left. That's my contribution to this playthrough. A broom.
Nope, I don't think we need it.
We don't need the broom. There we go.
That's it.
Quick save.
So the whole idea around the gauntlet came from Al and Justin kind of from the beginning pitching the idea that right at the start of the DLC where they're going to do a whole bunch of stuff to sort of draw you in, get you right into a bunch of action, and as you'll see once you play it yourself, subvert a lot of the things you might expect to happen at the beginning of the DLC. And do it in some interesting ways. I think people will really enjoy, once they see how this all comes together in context, the opening couple hours of the DLC.
It's also really refreshing, and it's been a while since I had gotten into some heavy combat in the game, to just get a reminder of how good the combat is when it's super challenging.
Yeah. A lot of times the problem with traps is, you know, you want the player to be able to sort of recognize when there's the danger and at least have the chance of not getting blown up without even knowing what killed them. So here, when you're in the gauntlet, you know you're dealing with a bunch of traps in sequence, so you have the chance to know, assess each room and try to figure out what the danger is.
Seriously, I just got totally turned around. Sorry, announcer.
Up the right there. To the right and up those stairs. And
yeah, there.
Sort of a U-turn.
There we go.
Yeah, and turn right here, hard right. Actually, that's the, up that ladder and to the left between the, there we go. Yeah.
Here?
No, that's like, you got to go between there, yeah. There may be a better way, but that's the way I remember to go.
Is that where I came from?
No, that's your exit there.
Time for things to get dangerous. See if he survives. What's next?
Shut up, Kevin. Laughing at me.
Yes, take it. Go, go, go.
Go, go, go.
Go, go, go. Keep going.
Wait till I run out of stamina right next to a mine. All right.
This is...
You, penitent man will pass. There we go. Go, go, go. No mire lurks for me. Oh. The hardest lockpick right down the middle ever.
Got it.
What the hell? God damn, Derek! That door's supposed to be boarded up!
God damn it, Derek.
So that's where you come...
Yeah.
That's where the mire
don't
lurks
go down
are.
There.
Let's
don't
not
go down
let's
there.
Let's not
yeah.
do that.
You played that one well.
I see your tricks. Raiders. Pesky raiders. What?
Move. But
must nope.
Yeah. Oh. I bet you we didn't save.
I did save.
Did you?
I did save. We should be good. That is a new hat. Now we've got a this is really for the kids, this Nuka World hat with
yeah.
the
our concept
spillover Nuka World girl.
Yeah. And that's one of our concept artists, John Grabato, painted that and the company has since put it on a million things because everyone really loves that pinup.
It's pretty sweet.
Yeah.
All right, so that... Sir Harksalot wins the Nuka Girl hat. Congratulations.
Very, very chivalrous. You might not be able to wear that.
Oh, I didn't. I didn't make
That's
it.
That's okay. We're good. No, we're... But just in case.
In the dry runs, we were pretty good at this.
Yeah, well, the gauntlet is a strange beast that requires you to assess it in a different way each time you go through.
Fun fact, at the office, in our lounge above our theater, we do have a gauntlet arcade game. So
yes.
I'll just pretend like that was an inspiration.
What the hell? God damn, Derek! That door's supposed to be boarded up!
Alright, so don't do what I did. Do that part.
And you hit. And I'm gonna look. Oh, just in case. I always like to blow everything up. Since I work on explosions, I like to see
Is that your explosion right there?
I don't know if that one is. When you blow up the turrets, that's my explosion.
Stim back.
Thank you.
Who doesn't love a good explosion?
When you blow up the barrels, that's my explosion. There's Grant's fire right there, one of our other effects artists. Let's see.
This room.
Yeah, so this one, so I was explaining to Matt earlier, I always just sort of guess my way through this, and I usually make it out alive. There's a poisonous gas, and I'm pretty sure it's flammable, so let's heal up, because, yeah. Oh, yeah. So maybe actually...
You took that like a pro, though. That damage off.
I always continuously heal when I'm in here because I don't know what's going on.
Is that the largest rat roach?
That might be.
Get out of there.
Just clean up in here a little bit.
I got the wounding sludge ready for you, too.
Somebody still dog me. That one was yours.
Nice.
I can't believe I have to do your work and mine. All right. Now, I don't know.
Wow, those are some long...
Yeah.
That is a brutal one.
This is my test. You just hit.
Oh, go back up.
What?
Go back up one. Use that bracket to the left. You can...
Say what now?
Do you know the brackets part? Go down two. So go to the... Right above the E.
This is you.
This is where you can clear out some of them. So
I always bring a companion.
Tries reset. Get some duds out of there.
Oh, nice. Yeah, I always bring a companion who can hack this stuff.
I had a stream the night the game came out where I was just guessing, and it was some sort of miracle. Oh, I did that one already. All right, so equipped we had 3, so that's probably an ED at the end.
Could be.
Which means we have a whole bunch of those. And then I just...
Got it.
Yeah, yes. That's what I do.
All right, nice job.
Use the force.
All right,
and I'll get it up. You back to the door. Rock and roll.
All right, so there was a lot of danger in that room that we circumvented that way.
Always guess, yes.
I just guessed the first 3, and if it didn't work out, then I tried the other ways to get through them.
I'm pretty sure there's a holotape in there that has the password, too, but... It's so frantic in there.
Oh,
you hear the breathing, and you want to just...
It's just stressful in there.
Save. Chat, thank you.
Thank you.
Breathe that fresh air.
Now, there's some new enemies. Those ants I mentioned earlier in here. They were giving me a hard time earlier. Let me see. Here.
A park of ants?
That.
While you can.
There's the flying ants to swarm, and then there's the ground ants. Oh, this one always takes so much. This is not the right weapon.
Feisty. Reminds me of those little clusters of bugs in the original Metroid.
Oh, I was just healing. Oh, I'm glad
it's
I
okay,
saved.
We saved.
We saved.
And it's a giveaway time. We are to the Monopolies now. So somebody's going to get Monopoly Fallout Collector's Edition featuring pieces like Vault Boy, Mini Nuke, Vault 111, Nuka-Cola bottle. Hey!
Yeah.
Nice.
I didn't realize that wasn't there. I don't have that Monopoly set yet.
Well, we'll have to hook you up with a Monopoly for coming on the show today. 10mm pistol and power armor helmet, and the winner is not the barber, it's the other barber. Congratulations on getting Monopoly. We'll DM you after the show.
So now we've kind of made it into Nuka World proper. We're out of the tunnels.
God damn, and... the whole stretch. Time for a little audience participation.
Yep. Just like when Anakin was trying to do the speeder race, taking pop shots.
Man, you go in Star Wars, and I was thinking, they have the high road, and you were screwed. But
yeah, I mean, a missile launcher is not going to help you out here because you're going to hit that fence.
I've found that the best way to deal with these guys has been to not deal with these guys. Oh, you can go down there.
There's a little, but they're always getting out of their way when they lose the advantage. So these are just raiders in the park who wanted to. Well, they feared the Ashmaker. Oh. Hold on a second.
Oh, Mr. Grenade.
I think one dropped.
Dogmeat, you better get out of there, son.
Oh, jeez, now we're under attack again.
Those are some crazy looking raiders.
Yep. So these are the factions, the Nuka World factions of raiders. Well, let's see here. What can I snipe these with? Oh. No, that's not going to work for that.
This didn't taste any longer. We're all going to die of boredom. All
right.
Maybe that's our cue. Oh, that's all those grenades.
Yeah.
Sorry, Dogmeat.
So these raiders are pretty tough to kill. And so if you do manage to pull off some kills here, it might seem like you can't get their gear through the fence, but there is a way to go back and get it.
Nice.
And of course, do a quick grab.
No lock on the door.
No. Yeah, because it's on the golden path, so you're able to get through without lock picking.
We have one prize left, actually. We have one more Monopoly.
So I think we're going to cut here. There's a exciting part coming up here that we want you to experience for yourself.
Well, I would say that was all very exciting.
Yeah.
And actually... we ended up being a decent team.
We didn't. I thought we might die a little bit more. I guess we died about as much.
We died just as much as we needed to give away the prizes.
Yeah, but don't forget we had only one piece of armor on.
You could also say maybe we rigged it so we died that many times and we're actually very good at the game.
Yeah. All right, so we're going to go to the nearest thing. I'm going to let you have a conversation.
So when you come out on the other end of a lot of excitement in there, you're leaving that place and you're heading into, is this like the main pavilion of the park? Or?
Yeah, this is the hub, the Nukatown, USA.
It's a pretty awesome sign. And
is this a good point to talk about this map?
Yeah, let's pull
up
the map.
That's since we're talking about where you're coming out here. Kevin, is that?
Let's go to...
all right, here, I'm going to pause this. You can look at the map.
You got that? Mm-hmm. So where we've come out, let's see here. There's the cola cars there. There's the transit station where we started. So we were underground here. And then if you remember the teaser we released at E3, it sort of flew right here in front where you could see the main gate and then over the rest of the park. So that gives you a little bit of... grounding.
So it's kind of to scale, that map? Or
yeah, so this map is to scale. You know, it's taken from screenshots in the game. So it's if you were to fly way up in the game and superimpose this over, you'd kind of have a pretty close one-to-one. And our one of our graphic artists, Natalia, did an amazing job, spent a lot of time capturing all the detail in there. She also made the Nuka World logos and the logo you see on your shirt that's over the main gate. So kudos to her.
She does all the Vault Boys too, right?
Yeah, she does all the Vault Boy animation. She did a great job. And I went to the amusement park for a little break the other day, and the map looked quite similar to this.
You went to Nuka World?
No, I went to King's Dominion, and it was nice to be able to see a real working map looking so much like our in-game one. And you can pick this map up in-game.
You can pick it up in game. You can get like a wallpaper type size on Bethesda Net. We have a story up, And I believe starting tomorrow at 24th. GameStop and EB Games Canada, you can go into the store and for free just say, I want the Nuka World map.
Yeah.
And they'll give it to you. So you should do
that. Oh, and it, just in case, I don't know if this is out there, but it has a nice on the back.
This one's been in my office for like 2 weeks now,
yeah,
and it's damaged as
yeah.
As
well,
one
you said
would expect.
I think this one got a little steamy when you had it in the bathroom for a little while.
Yeah, yeah, that's it. So here we are, and I wanted to. We're not going to spoil a lot here, but since you showed off all the locations, Neera is the perfect person to talk to. Yes, sure is.
As a matter of fact, it is.
Well, I have the souvenir shirt, but...
We're so happy to welcome you to Nuka World.
Like dog meat back there.
Before you set off on your grand Nuka adventure,
look at that
let
face.
Me tell you about error. System malfunction.
Are you finished wasting my time, you filthy low-life scabber? Because I'm getting bored, and when I get bored, I get violent.
Say that again, and your malfunctioning system is going to be the least of your problems.
So a lot of people had commented online that calling Neera Bottle. So Neera is actually a new addition to the park right before it got destroyed. And she was sort of a greeter bot, like an information bot. So she's technically not Bottle that you see the Bottle in Cappy.
Would she be a friendly friend of Bottle?
Yeah, she would be the Miss Pac-Man to Bottle's Pac-Man, something like that.
Tell me more about this tampering incident.
Internal systems monitoring recorded an unauthorized shutdown with functionality.
Mm-hmm.
My audio receptors recorded the entire event, and I submitted a holotape.
Sure.
Now, don't you worry.
Sure. Yeah, so she's had a little tampering with her system, so she has sort of a split personality. Another great example of our quest designers going crazy, and actually a good thematic example of the Raiders and Rides theme that's throughout Nuka World. It's that contrast of ultraviolets and a decaying cartoon sculpture, or you know, just creating that really even the good versus evil that you can sort of play through. That creates a lot of fun opportunities and a lot of drama and tension. And so we always try to think like Raiders and Rides when you have something cute and something crazy right next to each other. And so I guess that opened up a quest for me.
Tell me about the different areas of the park.
And then she, I love this rundown.
Set a course for the stars in the galactic zone and see the amazing future of mankind's journey into space. Explore starport
study the
Nuka
map while she talks.
And blast into adventure aboard the Nuka Galaxy roller coaster. Travel back in time to Dry Rock Gulch, where you can walk the dusty streets of a frontier town.
We do have one more giveaway. We have one more Monopoly, and if we die, we will give that away. Otherwise, we'll find a way to give it away.
We might have to blow ourselves up to give that away.
We could do that.
Challenge the hedge maze and climb the towering treehouse where you'll enjoy a
so the she's talking about the zones, which I think a lot of people have seen from the initial write-up that got posted during E3 and obviously from the map. When we were laying out the park, we really wanted each zone to sort of be transportive in that you, if you go to the feeling of the Wild West when you're in the middle of that zone, or the feeling of the World of Tomorrow when you're in the Galactic Zone. So once you're inside the walls of any given zone, we did a lot of work to make new custom artwork that really transported you. It didn't feel like any other zone or anything like in the base game.
That's cool. I mean, and it's totally appropriate for a theme park to do that.
Yeah. And as far as we could, we took that into the enemies you fight in that zone and to the weapons you might use or close. There's not one for every zone, but there's a lot of stuff across the board that lets you sort of role play within that zone and interact with that part of the story.
Cool. That was Neera's pretty great. That's a lot of good banter right there from her. All right, so I think I wanted to go here.
So we've got one little last fun thing to wrap things up. We are heading over to the Nuka-cade. So all those tokens.
Just be careful. And, yeah, go around there.
It has to be.
Yeah. Oh, and then we were going to. We had a saver with the tickets.
Yep, new kid. Yep. Here. Yeah.
So we'll just jump in there. Can you romance Nira?
No, she's never a companion.
So here we are, and in the Nuka Cage, you can use your tokens and
yeah. So what you want to do here? Can I?
Yeah, you got
it. This was definitely a passion project for a lot of us, especially Andrew Langlois, the level designer, who really pulled this together. It's making sure we got this Nuka Cage in there. So, and in fact, this, I believe, dates back to someone's jam project, too, where they, for those who don't know the game jam, we've shown some of the videos, but it's a week every so often, every couple of years, where the devs just do whatever they want that could go in the game. And I'm pretty sure there was a game jam at one point where I think Robert made Ski Ball and a couple other games just because, hey, wouldn't it be great? And then when Nuka World came along, you know, those two things came together. So if we go and make sure we have some... Where is it? Pre-war money. Yeah, we got some pre-war money. Since this is a pre-war machine, we can go ahead and use that to get some tokens.
Nice.
Get a few more. And then pop in here. We'll see. We've got a pipe auto pistol. We'll see what score I can get with the recommended pistol here. And then you just put your token in. Hopefully I have enough ammo, yeah. And we're off. And the score is going to be down at the bottom. You can tell how long you have to go as long as that music's playing.
Do you have a high score?
I count the tickets. You know, I see when I pick up the tickets at the end. That's what I do at Chuck E. Cheese when I'm with my kids, Simon and Ziggy. Hey, guys.
What is your go-to Chuck E. Cheese game?
I do Ski Ball. I try to get that high score in there, and they usually have a bonus where you get a whole bunch of extra tickets if you can get 450. So that's my game. My wife does the circling light where you have to stop it and get the bonus. Nice. And then you go up to the counter and you get nothing.
I think I got a Super Mario doll that was about this big when I was 7.
That must have cost thousands of tickets.
I think it was my birthday, so I think I think maybe my dad just said, just give him the doll.
I'll pay whatever it costs. All right. So the tickets should come out.
Any left?
Yeah. Still playing the music.
Oh, it's doing it. There you go.
Here we go. And you see the top left, 311. I think I got more earlier today when I was playing.
That's pretty good, though.
All right, so maybe you want to give it a shot with a different weapon? So the designers thought about the Nuka Cage earlier on as to whether or not they'd be able to you'd be able to cheat, use certain weapons or not. But they ended up just this is run by Raiders after all, so you can go in here and kind of do it how you want to.
Doing good.
Yeah. We're gonna share the prize though, so don't think your extra tickets are going to go just to you.
You know what? I think we know who would win this match. Let's just jump ahead. Where do we want to go next?
Let's try the Red Menace. So as we all know from the Pip-Boy game, there's a Red Menace, and he likes to throw bombs down at you. In this case, he likes to pop out. Oh, you need the weapons on the floor there.
Well, hey.
Sorry.
It was rigged from the start. No!
Commie Whacker is what you want to go with.
Commie Whacker, yeah. Okay.
So there you can get the Red Menace and just smash it with the Hammer of Democracy, or the Whacker of Democracy.
And his score was 0.
You got a lead a little bit. There you go, you got one.
That was a good tip.
Communism is hard to whack out entirely. It takes...
Years and years. A precise
hand with the democracy.
What did I get, like 45?
14.
You suck.
So that one's a little challenging.
All right, what else should we compete in?
Let's take, why don't you take a hoop shot over there?
All right.
So this one you don't use a weapon, right? You just use the pickup mechanism with the A button there.
Oh, all right. Well, that's a good use of the physics. So hold with A.
Yep.
And drop the balls everywhere.
Yeah.
I'm not on a timer, right?
Yeah, you are, but you can do this.
Oh.
Give it a little arc.
Come on. This is sports fans, this is Andre Drummond. Right there.
Oh.
Or DeAndre Jordan. Yeah. Jordan. There we go. That was a good looking shot. I think they're giving me point. No, don't.
No.
The mallet is not what you need here.
Oh, there you go. I think you might have gotten some points for getting your name right at the beginning of the test.
There we go.
Now you're getting some real.
He's on fire. They're giving me points for that. I'll take it. In the wasteland, they don't know what. All right. Wait, I have to do one from long range now.
Yeah, from downtown, as they say.
Steph Curry. No.
No.
Okay.
All right. So let's see. You've got,
what did I get? 1,000? Oh, right. Tickets. 31.
31. All right. I'm going to try slightly different technique here. I'm going to raiderize it. As we said many times when we were making the DLC, I'm going to raiderize this.
Kobe. Son of a.
So let's get this loaded up.
It was rigged from the start.
Oh. Drop. All right, off to go. Make it rain.
What?
That one's like a YouTube there video. Blocking me.
There you go. Nice job, Matumbo.
Oh, it's not. It's just not working the way it should.
You're getting. I think you've won.
Oh, so now I'm out of basketball. That's the drawback to my technique. I have to reload this thing.
And that. Is there another hoop shoot in here that you could have taken more balls from? Man.
I'm not sure.
James Naismith would have had to reinvent the hoop if it stuck there that many times. 70. Yeah, you definitely more than doubled up. Yeah. Kevin, should we give away the last Monopoly?
I'll run over and
do one more game, a little
ski ball here.
There it
that's
is.
Everyone's favorite. Frantics HD.
Frantics HD. Wow, you didn't leave any suspense to that. You are the last winner of Monopoly, so nice. We will DM you after the show, which is we're almost done here. We don't want to give away too much.
Oh, jeez,
Nancy.
No, what am I doing here?
Hold A. There you go, and then. Nice, overhand. My mom got kicked out of a bar for throwing overhand skee ball. She did not understand. That was a nice shot.
But you have a special technique I think you like to demo.
Yeah, I think it's everybody's dream to just not do that.
Oh, jeez. This is everyone's nightmare when the thing doesn't drop
Let's
enough.
Let's just...
balls there. There you go.
There we go. There we go. Hey there. Yeah, wow. Still.
Depth perception.
And I want to press.
There it is. There it is.
Get there. Oh my goodness. Do it. Do it. Oh. Yeah, Matt.
Look, there's some tickets on the floor.
You really got this technique down. There we go. Okay.
So you can find tickets and tokens throughout the park, and of course you can probably come with a ton of pre-war money if you've been collecting it as you go in the base game.
Well, that's an interesting technique. And one more for the road. Nope, I guess not. Just drop it. There it is. Ladies and gentlemen, the king of skee ball. Is going to do it. That's going to do it.
Yeah.
So I think we've shown a nice little tease of Nuka World. It comes out next week on August 30th, PS4, Xbox One, PC.
Mm-hmm.
We have a couple more stories on BethesdaNet going up this week, so a little more to tide you over. And we hope you enjoy it.
Yeah, it should be a really exciting week.
Yeah, it's been awesome. We died a lot. We gave away prizes. And a lot more Nuka World to see once you play it. So thanks a lot, guys.
We're really looking forward.
Thank you.